Hello and welcome to ITC Techshare. I'm Tom Grissom. Today I'd like to give you a quick overview of Ink2Go, which is a screen annotation program. I'm using this on Windows 8 and it does have a little bit of problems whenever you go over to the Metro side of things, but I am actually using the Ink2Go recorder tool to record this screencast. And if I bring in my charms bar and open up my Metro interface, you can see that it is recording. However, I cannot do annotations on the start screen modern interface side. So I need to go back to the desktop side in order to do screen annotations. So this is typical. We have the pen here, so we have all the different selections. Let's choose white. Since I've got a white or a blue background, white will contrast with that a little bit better. So I can come out here, do all kinds of different annotations, whatever it is that I would like to do. And I have a clear screen, so I'm going to clear off all those annotations. I also can use this as a whiteboard mode, so if I'd like to, I can blank out the screen. And now then, since I was using white, I need to change my pen tool to, let's do blue. So I can come out here and write whatever it is that I would like to do. And if I had this connected to the projector, of course everybody would be seeing up on the overhead projector or an HDTV. So just to give you an idea, and I'm using the Surface Pro's digital pen, always comes in handy. And if I don't like whatever I did, there is a clear screen tool, so let me just clear that out. If I would like, I can come out and highlight it, but I also have a couple of other choices for my background. So let me use this little pull down right here, and let's say that I want to do a blackboard instead of a whiteboard. Now let me change my pen color, and let's do white again, like white chalk. So now then, just for contrast, more of a traditional white chalk and blackboard approach. So I can come out here, make my annotations, whatever it is. I do have the clear button. I can make, let me just go out here. I can do like, this is page one. I can add a page here. So this is page two. And you'll notice right up here that it's increment page 2 of 2. Let's add another page. So now I'm on page 3. If you look up here, it says page 3 of 3. And then I can cycle back through all of those. So on the desktop side, this is very, very handy. I'm going to clear that out, and then I'm going to get rid of that, so it brings me back to my desktop. Now, just to show you a trick, I've not been able to get this to work on the modern interface, but if I go over here and open up Internet Explorer, if I try writing, it won't let me do anything here because I'm on the modern side, the modern apps. It won't interact with that at all. But let me show you a little trick here. If I swipe up from the bottom and go to the wrench, whenever I'm in IE, there's an option that says View on Desktop. So I can essentially take this page over to the desktop, open it up, and now then, since I am on the desktop version of this, let me choose blue, I can now annotate on top of this. This is a web page that I'm annotating on top of. So I could say, okay, if you click here, that will take you to our podcast. If you click here, this is our YouTube channel. And then if you go over here, this is our blog. So you can go up there. If you make a mistake, you've got an eraser here, so you can erase that away and then go back to your pen tool, write it again. So whenever you want to get rid of all of those annotations, you can clear the annotations, or you can take a screenshot if you'd like to. And then I'm going to clear this out. And then I need to switch back to mouse mode because I want to close this browser out. So this is like I'm back to mouse, and then I can close the browser out. The webcam's not working. I can't get it to switch to the front camera. If I select, we can record. But I've got it folded over, so you're just seeing black there, but I haven't been able to get that to work on the front camera. But this is very, very useful. Let me come up here. Let me open up Internet Explorer here again. And let's go out here. I'll show you another very handy thing with this. Let's say that you want to, let me come out here and go to our YouTube channel and browse our videos, and let's go here to this one on Ellis and Dice. Turn that down. I'm just going to mute this until I get to Okay, so I'm going to pause the video here, and one of the things that you can do, you can actually annotate on top of YouTube videos. So let's do white so we can contrast. And in this episode, Shauna is going to show you how to do an accordion fold make that particular little cutout there. So once again, I can clear that out. Whenever I'm done, switch back to mouse mode, close it out. Yes, I want to close all tabs, and then I'm finished. And I am actually going to, right now, click this little button right here. This is my record. We're recording right now. And whenever I press that, that will end the recording. So thanks for watching. Until next time, this is Tom Grissom. Keep on learning.